Hello and welcome back to Let's Play some Dink Smallwood mods, D-mods. Today we'll be playing The Golden Duck by Toof. Dink goes in the Golden Duck bar for a drink. There's gotta be a joke in there somewhere, right? Let's check it out. A bar adventure. Can't continue, we haven't done anything yet. Welcome to this unofficial Dink Smallwood game modification. I'm your personified narrator. Yeah, that sounded cool and professional. So let me tell you a story. No, not a story, but an epic saga of epic proportions about Dink's epic journey across the seven continents and beyond the seven seas. Cool music. In a faraway land. Man, this is such a cliche narrative. I'm tired of this kind of crap. You know what? Screw this piece of beep. I'm not reading a single word more from this script. Long story short, Dink went to Tsardom of Vasiona, a land ruled by Tsar Toof the First. Not to fight villains or anything, but as a regular tourist, one evening while he was strolling down the streets of the capital city of Raskolov. Hey, is this the famous Golden Duck Bar? It is, isn't it? Yeah, it must be. Well, aren't you a brainiac? I wonder how did you deduce that? Was it the bar sign hanging from above, combined with the sign in front of you that says The Golden Duck? Or was it the giant statue of Golden Duck over there that gave it away? Sheesh. No need to insult my intelligence. I don't throw insults at non-existent things. Hey, give me a break. I'm a foreigner. Everything is new here for me. Relax, I'm joking. I can see that you're a little bit lost. I actually wanted to visit this place tonight, although a little bit later. First I plan to go see Toof's palace. I must have made a wrong turn a few streets too early. Well, now that you're here, you might as well come in. Meh, why not? I'm tired of walking anyway. I've read about this place in the tour guide, but can you give me some details? Sure, shoot. Okay, we have dialogue selection, awesome. Why are you guarding the entrance and not some soldier? This place is expensive, and we have some high-class clientele. A mage like me is by far more effective when dealing with potentially dangerous drunk people or thieves or something else. Sure, a guard would probably suffice, but rich folks don't want to think about it. I wonder if he says the same thing the second time through, yeah. Give me some general information. Golden Duck is a top-class restaurant. We have some live performances tonight. Only creme de la creme of the society comes here. Anything else? Can I go inside? Preposterous! I'm here to keep potential guests out of the bar. Of course you can come in, idiot. The question is, do you want to? So, do you want to get in? Nay. Not your cup of tea, huh? You're lost, kid. Thus ends this crappy story about Dink. I wonder who is supposed to pay me for this. That would be me, narrator. Toof, did you write that horrible introduction? So the game ends. Yeah, I was kind of out of ideas. The game ends if we don't go in. Why do you ask? It's not like it's the worst thing that you can find. True, but still. Superficial storytelling is like yellow journalism. What's done is done. Want to grab a drink? The daiquiri at the Golden Duck? Sure. I'm always for that. Pity. This D-mod had potential. Oh, what'd he say? We might see it again after the actual end, because I'm gonna go actually in the bar this time. I wanna not continue, because it's gonna leave me where they were walking off. Welcome, welcome. I wanted to look around outside, but I guess we don't do that. I like the music. Mama told me let's go. Whatever that song is actually called. I don't think that's the actual title of it. So, do you want to get in? Yay! Be sure to try out the Duck Daiquiri. Just ask the bartender for one. Wow, this place is fancy. Time to taste that Duck Daiquiri. So how are Delaney and something good their daughter Nia turned 4 last month? Time does fly. How's the little one? Nia? Such a restless child. Really hard for her parents. Impossible to control, huh? Little devil. We barely managed to exchange a sentence. When she wants something, nothing will stop her. Even threats or a little beating doesn't help. Oh, geez. Having such personality can be useful later in life. Unless you make a wrong turn while you're a teen. Yeah, because no one will be able to stop you from going astray. And any attempt to yield even worse results. And any attempt will yield worse results. It's strange how we are unable to realize that time will get us. Yeah, you think you can do everything, and suddenly... the priorities change when body starts refusing certain things. I miss those days. But if you pass that age, going in the right direction, all while being really stubborn, the future may be bright. We're all good at something, I guess, no matter what type we are. There is the good and the bad in everything. Yeah, the balance. I wish I could have kids. Okay, Thanos. You two still have a problem with that? Sadly, yes. An unsolvable problem. Have you considered adopting? We had, but we gave up on it. So you may never have children. What does that mean to you? Honestly, I don't know. How long do these people go on for? Are you afraid that no one will carry on the family name? To be honest, not exactly. You know, sometimes you have to exploit the negative. Exploit the negative? You can't have kids. You consider it to be a bad thing, right? Of course. Our lives differ, my friend. Having no children gives you time for other things. Like making D-mods. And having no kids isn't gonna kill you. You're fairly rich also, so use that money. Money isn't gonna bring me kids. True, but you can donate it and help other kids. You can travel the world, get extra education. There is no written rule, or maybe you can adopt kids. That we all must live and die in the same way. Make your life with what you've got. Use problems to gain higher ground in other areas. You, at least, have that opportunity. Exploit the negative. Cheer up, pal. For the negatives in life? For the negatives in life. Chin? What does that mean? Eleonora. Dorothy and Eleonora. Okay, finally. Let's read this first. I can't read it. Stupid sign. Can't read you. Do you mind? We're talking here. Excuse me then. Save. Yo, bartender! Yo! What you got here? What you need? I was trying to talk to this guy, but I'm talking to the bartender. Small talk and chat. How's going tonight? The usual. Not many people, but the business is good. Do you own this place? I wish to, but no. We don't know who the owner is exactly. We? You mean the staff? How come? Much money was thrown and invested in this place, so probably some rich guy made a place for rich guys. Maybe he's even here tonight. When you have that kind of money, you do not want to be famous. Someone may try to rob you. That, and there is no legal way one can hoard so much cash. So I'd keep my identity a secret too if I were him. It's the best way to have a peace of mind. Yeah, I see the point. Is it the same time every time? It's the same thing every time. Rumors, gossip, the hot stuff. Any gossip? Well, Tsar Tooth just returned to his castle from some vague errand. He covers this land for 3 years now, and we still never saw him. Never saw him? What the? Is that even possible? Haha, so you aren't familiar with our history? No, tell me. Tooth has overthrown the former king 3 years ago, and declared himself a Tsar. But nobody ever saw this guy, or knows anything about him. It's very strange. Tell me about it. Some speculate that he owns this very place. Some even say that he is a duck. A talking duck? That's not impossible, you know. Yeah, right. The guy is a duck, I keep telling you. Have you ever saw a talking duck? I have. You're insane, old man. And you, young man, shouldn't choke with seniors like that. But, no buts. He's old and senile. Leave him be.
I'm not senile, I keep telling you.
I have a friend in Bronstuk or something. And he had a talking duck. It was he or she. See what I mean, kid? Show some respect for the old man, and don't strain his brain. Keep it peaceful, gents. We're all adults here. Dink is thinking, I better keep my mouth shut. Now, can I talk with the old man? Oh, I can't even walk over there. Oh, I can, okay. I miss my younger days. All I can do now is drown in alcohol, hoping it will dull the pain in my bones. Things changed. This used to be a palace of Yetarina Vetrov, until Tooth came and executed most of the former nobles. Took all their estates? God, I love that woman. I'd be delighted to chat with you. Rare are those who want to listen to me. Not that I blame them. Life is a funny thing. You spend years gaining knowledge, experience, and wisdom, and when you reach the peak, you suddenly forget your own name. Senile and demented. Oh, the irony. The old man looks bitter. Let's try cheering him up. You don't seem senile nor demented. Yeah, but for how long? Well, if it didn't hit you so far, I doubt it ever will. That's how these things go. So you've kept your wisdom. I admire your optimism, boy. And thanks for trying to cheer me up. Here, take this amulet of mine. It brings to me only pain, reminding me of my beloved Yetarina. It's worth quite a lot, but money won't bring me back my youth. But it can give you money to enjoy yours. Yeah, we're gonna take it. Hey, thanks. Enjoy while you can. Got an amulet, I guess, and coins. Tooth killed most of the nobles. People who wear silk clothes these days are merchants. Bastards without manners. I thought it was something I could see in inventory, but nope. Alright, so I don't want to get the duck thing yet, but let's recommend me something. Recommendation, eh? I wish more guests asked for that. Here at the bar, we have plenty of good stuff. Premium domestic icicle vodka, distilled 6 times. There's also Boncardo ice wine, excellent with dessert. Or perhaps, if you're a beer guy like me, Pig Pale Ale. From Bar Brawl Brewery. Oh my god, they're the best. And we have our signature cocktail, of course, Duck Daiquiri. Icicle vodka, rum, lime juice, and a dash of bitters. Yum. Alright. Look around before we... Oh my, look at that back there. Enjoy our finest selection of food. Oysters from the White Sea. All colors of caviar. Coca Isle ducks. Medium rare dragon steak. And much more. Our food is prepared by the finest chefs on this world. Oh, the king is here. Warm. All in order? I'll fry you alive if you approach us again. Damn. How about some dessert? For the 100th time this evening, I'm on a diet. Oh, he's going for the king now. Would you like a drink? Oh, now you remembered to ask me that? Poor guy. Take a seat and I'll be right with you. You can't talk to them? The waiter is crazy. He really pisses me off. Food here is fantastic. But I'm not hungry tonight. I really enjoy this gin. Triple sec really goes well in the mix. These people don't exist. Alright. Hello, Your Highness. Munch, munch. He's got a... Oh, that's a question mark. Are you expecting something? Get your own food. I thought it was on his crown. Pork chops here are amazing. Burp. Oh yeah, I needed that. Okay. Can't move when that happens. There we go. Oh, I can go through there. What is this? Oh, there's a save point over here. I didn't mean to do that. What am I doing? Pressing the wrong key, that's what I'm doing. I wonder if he said the same thing. What is that? What are those spheres moving? Like smoke or something? Looks like a teleport. I wonder what this is for. Odd thing, this one. Pick through the bookshelf. Okay, unknown poem. The blue sky doesn't exist. We are all on death's to-do list. The truth is clouded by a thick mist. And all of this makes me pissed. Meh. That was funny. Little Red Riding Hood. Once upon a time, happened a terrible crime. Little Red Riding Hood was walking through the woods. But the wolf stole all of her goods. Then he ate her grandmother. With the girl he couldn't bother. He was already full. Then she ran away. She hid in a bale of hay. She waited for the night. Until she felt the time was right. To get back and kill the creature. But the wolf had scary features. So she ran away once more. Running from that blood and gore. She moved from village to the city. She grew up, became pretty. She became famous and rich. Sipping margaritas on sandy beach. Her granny left unavenged. But, screw it. Life is good now. The end. You go, girl. Oh, got stuck on a bookshelf. Cocktails. All cocktails have primary ingredient, which comes in first, secondary, which comes in second, and a third one, which, you can guess. Most famous cocktails with vodka as the primary ingredient are Vasiona Dream, Tsar's Crown, and Vecherinka. Some are stronger than others. Vecherinka has amaretto as a second ingredient, while Tsar's Crown uses gin as second. So, for example, Vasiona Dream uses ginger beer as a second ingredient. while Tsar's Crown uses it as a third, but the most common practice is to use lime juice as a third ingredient. Another exception of the rule is Cast Outcast Cocktail. It has orange juice as a finishing touch. This is the most confusing book ever. Hello, sir. Hello. Hi there. Quiet guy looks at you with interest. About that thing in the corner, yeah. Ask about this room. What's this room for? This is a mini library. Really? A library and a bar is... interesting. People can sit here and read while eating and drinking? Yeah, that's the concept. Very interesting. I support that. Sure, me too. It's a good attempt to make people more educated. Sure, sure. Dink's not a talking type, I guess. Chat. How's going? Good. I'm reading a book. A book about cocktail making. There's one on the shelf as well. Ask about the thing in the corner. What's that thing in the corner? It's a jukebox. Pick a song, it will play throughout the entire bar. Except in the trance hall, that is. Say, could I ask you for a favor? Maybe. I need to retrieve something. It's a memory storage card for the jukebox. How does it look? Like a lightning. Jukebox memory card that looks like a lightning. Not very descriptive. Politely ask for more details. Sir, I'm gonna need more than that. I suppose. It's completely black with flashing lightning on top. I can't explain it better. And when I find it, and plug into jukebox and play New Junk City. I want to hear that song. Now leave me be. Jeez. We don't have that option anymore, right? Never mind. Bon voyage. Well, we can't play stuff. Guerrilla Radio? Well, we can. Let's rage against the machine. I think it is. Give me one reason. To say that. How's it go? I'll turn back around. Now I'm gonna. I use Windows Live Movie Maker to edit, so my voice is gonna be a little off from the music playing. So I'm not that bad with my timing. Oi, como va? I know this song. Oh, hey, Joe. Awesome. Little mini versions of these songs. Oh, I love it. I'm going to leave that one playing. Just check these out first. Bray. Scent of a Woman, Tango. We're gonna leave Hey Joe Ryan. Is that what the shadow's coming from? Golden Duck Power Station. Note that power switch on first floor only affects things that are plugged into the floor. Other electric consoles are on the lower levels. Really? What was that? Power switch on first floor only affects things that are plugged into the floor. This power switch? Looks like some sort of button.
pleasure.
I can't go in, though? Oh, I have to hit this? Doors are leading somewhere below. You know, before I hit this, let's just look around some more in other areas. I'm loving this. I really like the song to begin with, so. I'm getting stuck on stuff. So what's back here? Oh, what is this? I don't think I should go there without permission. Can I look at these things? Okay. Let's order the duck thing. Duck daiquiri. Bartender, give me duck daiquiri! But of course, sir. 3 ounces of premium icicle vodka. These guys are saying new things. Spilled into shaker. 3 ounces of premium cocoon rum. Yum. And that also. Wee bit of lime juice and dash of bitters. Do wish to have a shortcut sometimes. Put ice into shaker. Time for the magic move. There's a shortcut called charm. Shake, shake, shake. A woman without looks is the same as a man without charm, huh? For certain things, yeah. Pours everything into ice-cool, old-fashioned glass. Women have absolutely poor choice when it comes to us. Enjoy your drink, sir. Bet you wouldn't talk like that if you were their choice. You mean their first choice? Ha 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 ha. I'll have to let that sink in, but what about women? Ah, women. Women know exactly what they want. But alas, they tend to confuse these things. Sounds awfully similar. No, no. If a guy doesn't get sex, he knows he isn't gonna get it. So he pursues other two, trying to convince himself. What other two? That will fix his problem. That's stupid. He knows the difference, but he doesn't know what he needs. Women, on the other hand, confuse things. Say they confuse security with solace. Or they think that occasional sex and a little solace is security. Even though a guy is a total moron, they stick with him. Until, of course, the bubble bursts. But get this, if a man thinks he can find solace by pursuing security, while his woman thinks security is solace, both of them get what they want and can be happy. Until one of them realizes the error in thinking. Man, you really gave that a thought, huh? Who knows? For women? For women. Clink! Oh, that the chin is supposed to be clink? Oh, we're back to this. How do I... Okay. The bartender puts a napkin on the table and serves Dink's order. Thank him. Thank you. My pleasure, sir. The cocktail is a piece of art. A piece of lime is hanged, hung at the edge of the glass next to cutted straws. The alcohol mixture is being cooled by crushed ice, and on top of that are a few mint leaves. Dink decides to gulp it down. Gulp. I can see you've enjoyed that one, sir. Another hit, I guess? Hell yeah, keep him coming. Of course, sir. Puts ingredients. Shake, shake, shake. Drink it while it's cool. Another perfection lies in front of Dink. Dink decides to sip it slowly. Sip. sip. Sir, could I bother you to settle your bill? I actually do have money. My shift is nearly done. Time to pay for welcome and stay. What's the difference between pay the man and just pay? No problem at all. How much do I owe? That would be 1,000 gold pieces, sir. 1,000 gold pieces? I don't have that much. I'm sure you can figure something out, sir. I gotta settle this somehow. I can't pay? How much is my bill again? 1,000. But I didn't know that damn drink cost so much. Prices are clearly listed on that pole. I couldn't read it. This isn't the first case a customer can't pay. You can settle the bill by finishing some jobs here. Just ask any staff member, and they might give you something. You can even help me here, sir. After you earn enough, come back here to settle everything.
Ugh.
Oh, didn't mean to do that.